Now, it might seem that things are going pretty well for Esther and Mordecai. After all, they saved the king's life. But Haman had something else up his sleeve. Or wherever. You see, nothing could be worse for Haman than for his enemy Mordecai to be on a king's good side. If the king liked Mordecai more than him, it might jeopardize his position as the second in command. So Haman came up with his own sneaky little plan.
Your Highness, I believe there is much gold here.
Really? Those peonies are no longer here.
A much greater danger may await you now.
How's that possible?
With permission, Your Highness, I'll tell you how.
Go on.
It's my duty to inform you, and if I'm correct, to ignore this great emergency would be neglect. It's the motto of my office, serve and protect. There are those who walk among us who show no respect.
Really?
The law must be adjusted. There are those who can't be trusted.
Oh my goodness, tell me about these people.
Sneaky little family who do sneaky little things, who stick their sneaky noses into matters of the king. I fear if they're not dealt with, the prospect makes me weep. A zucchini shaped sarcophagus is where you'll sleep.
Really? The nerve! I am disgusted!
There are those who can't be trusted.
That sure doesn't sound like a nice family.
Nope. Your Highness, I believe we must act with speed.
Agreed! Say the word! I'll give you what you need!
A simple solution, but you must act now!
Well, how can I help?
With permission, Your Highness, I'll tell you how.
Go on!
After careful calculation, I've got this thing. We'll send them to the dreaded Isle of Kikaling. But before I can take action, we have to close that deal. And it needs the kingly imprint of your royal seal.
I agree! They must be busted!
There are those who can't be trusted. That sneaky little family who do sneaky little things, who stick their sneaky noses in the mothers of the king. But crime against the king, their punishment is still.